All right. Now that you're a little over halfway through the season, is this kind of where you expected the team to be at this point?
Yeah, I think so. You know, we're a couple games over 500. Obviously, we'd like to be in a better spot record-wise. But I think we've been really competitive with the schedule we've put together. I think our pitchers have been throwing the ball really well. I think they had a rough go at Virginia Tech. But other than that, their ERAs have been great, and they've been keeping us in a lot of these close games. So, yeah, I think we're in a good spot. I think, you know, it's a long season, and you're going to kind of take your hits here and there. And we took a little bit of a hit at Virginia Tech, but this group really fights, you know, and they're gonna push through it and make some adjustments and figure some things out, and then we'll get rolling this week.
Okay, and you know, after a tough series like this past weekend, what do you tell your team to get them refocused for the road ahead?
Yeah, you know, it was tough. We took 2 of 3 from them last year, so we always want to shoot to be better than last year. And Virginia Tech came out and they hit the ball really well. It seemed like whatever we were throwing them, they were getting a good piece on it. And our hitters, you know, at certain points, you know, I had some things rolling, but we needed a total team effort, and it just didn't all click together. So, you know, we're not gonna hang on to that series and dwell on it. I think there's some things we can learn from it and get better from it, and then you know, kind of put it in the rearview mirror and just kind of move on. So.
Okay, and what can you say about the play of Tatiana Cortez? You know, after a slow start in the beginning, she seems to, you know, really be rolling right now.
Yeah, she's doing great. She hit .625 on the weekend, and her slugging percentage was 1.1 something. So she's just getting in there and just attacking early in the counts and picking out good pitches, and has been really clutch for our team. It seems like, you know, we're getting some runners on base, and then we're able to hand the bat over to her. So she's doing what we know she can do and what we expect her to do. So it's good to see her getting into a good groove.
And, you know, weather permitting, the home opener is tomorrow. And then, you know, after that, next 12 games will be in Massachusetts. So, you know, how good is it to finally play some softball in-state?
Yeah, we got a little bit of snow still on the field, so we're trying to figure out if we're going to play Wednesday. But regardless, when you look at our schedule, like you said, 12 games, all within a pretty close area to BC. So it's just that time of the year where we've been on the road for quite a while now. So it's going to be nice for these kids to sleep in their own beds and then kind of wake up, go to class, and then play a home game. So you know, it's. The hours kind of decrease a little bit, so we're not going to be on the road for a game for 8 hours. It's going to be, you know, 3, 4, 5 hours, whatever it is. So I know they're excited to get out on the field.